Okay, so in this video, I wanted to fix up a tiny little boo-boo that I had made in a previous video on pose-based deformation. I showed you input and output mesh plugging in the node editor to try and allow yourself to take advantage of the different changes in pose. And it would go to this copy of the mesh. And you could go ahead and do your deformations and bring it back, and it would be all great and wonderful. But it appears something has changed, and it'll work for things like the armpits and stuff like that. But when we get into like a rotation of the leg and I pull it back down, it's the information is now global information, and so the points kind of stay stuck. They don't readdress the change in position, which is unfortunate. So because I don't have an immediate way around it, I'm going to show you an alternate use for that method of plugging one shape into another and how you can make use of it. So what I have here is, let's go to the UV texture editor and open that up a little bit wider if it wants to. And we'll look at that, and I've got one set of UVs here and a really horrible set of UVs here. And we'll just pretend that I want to take these UVs and put it on this one because they're so lovely. Well, if I wanted to do that, I can go up and I could go under mesh and use transfer attributes. And if they're exactly in the same pose, I could transfer all UV sets, and it's using, you know, world space, so I'd have to put them directly over top. Or I could go and use local space, and the center is pretty much the same since this is a duplicate of this mesh. So there's possibilities there. But what if, for whatever reason, it is not in that pose anymore? What if something has had to change because of the way it's being rigged, or perhaps in the middle of an animation and I don't want to go ahead and reset everything because I'm worried about what's going to happen? All sorts of potential issues that could come up. So I want to transfer the UVs of this guy onto this guy, but I can't use that tool set. I can take this guy's UVs and I can plug him directly into there. So I'm going to make sure that this mesh is a duplicate of this mesh before I do all this. And if for some reason you do need to do like a transfer from a different topology, it is possible. If I change the topology on this and I plug it into here, it's going to change the topology that's on this one here based on what I'm plugging in. So it's important that the topology be the same. However, to transfer, like, I could have another version of this guy, use the transfer UVs that I just showed there, then delete history, and then use this guy to plug in as I'm about to show. So there's multiple steps sometimes to deal with this, but you know, these are workarounds. Anyways, let's move forward, and we'll take these two guys, and in the node editor, which is found under Window Node Editor, we'll go boink. Oh my god, nodes everywhere. Don't worry. Okay, so we've got a cool little base shape here, and if I click on it, you can see this guy. Oops. And this guy is him over there. And note that it doesn't say original shape. There is an original shape ones down here, like originals. It's not those. Those are not the ones we're playing with. These are not the droids you're looking for. If you use one of those, bad things will happen. So use the correct ones. We have this wonderful tweak node. So I've got this guy, and we'll go over here, and the tweak node is usually applied once you get deformers. So I've applied a deformer by putting a skin bind on him, and the tweak node was created. And it also has a tweak set that's here. We're not seeing it, but I could make it more visible. I have to open this guy up and open this guy up, and it's important that I open them two up because if I try and drag across, it won't allow me to plug in until it sees the input geometry. we'll go out mesh into input geometry. Oh my God, what happened? Well, what happened is now he has those UVs. And what's going on here? Well, I could show you a little bit more about what's going on. Let's say I wanted to go in and grab a lovely edge loop like this one. Press Control Delete. Oh my God. That was lovely, right? How about if I wanted to add some new geometry? Oh my God. So you have to be careful about this. It's, again, like I said, the same mesh back and forth between the two of them. That's the important part of it. And then we can connect that. Now, what's kind of neat, and I haven't tested anything with regards to this, but if you select this guy, which is the connection, I've done that connection, I've transferred the UVs essentially, and I delete that connection, I've discovered, for whatever strange reason, that the UVs remain. And I can then take this guy and delete him forever. But if for whatever reason you do need to, you know, keep them connected, as I have them here, you can turn this guy into an intermediate shape. And that's found under here, under Object Display, Intermediate Shape, and he basically disappears. He's no longer visible or selectable in the scene. He doesn't show up really anywhere anymore. He's just kind of hiding in amongst the nodes, doing ninja activities, and no longer will bother you. And all his purpose is just to transfer his information onto this other guy. So that's one potential use of the intermediate object. Another use, let me just clear the scene. Take this object here. And one more time. Sound effects are very important. Always have to make the whoop sound when doing extrudes. And we'll go over to the modeling toolkit. Click, click, click. So that was just holding down control and using left mouse button to add those guys in. Now I've got six pieces of history on this guy. If I go back into object mode, you can see them. I've got my extrudes and my poly splits. Now, say for whatever reason, what I want to do is I want to have my extrudes, the history of them, deleted. I want to collapse that information in the original structure of this. And I want to keep the poly splits for some reason. There's various different reasons why you may want to keep certain deformers for specific purposes. It could be that you want to keep some of the history around for animation purposes, but they're technically modeling tools. And if you go under here, Edit Delete by Type History, we have history and non-deformer history. The non-deformer history takes most modeling tools like PolySplit, Extrude, etc., which can be animated. They can be changed over time. Like if I take my Extrude here and I take any of these values like this guy right here, I can right click on him and I can key that selected object. So I can key its position in space, doing things to, you know, make like things grow or something like that. So we can key that stuff and maybe want to keep it around. So what we can do is we can interrupt the flow of this stuff using intermediary objects. So that's what we're going to do. So I'm going to go ahead and take this object and Windows and Node Editor. We've got this. And we'll get its input output connections and we'll get the entire list of all the stuff. And there's the poly extrude, 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 and then our splits. And I want to interrupt this flow, delete all this back history, but keep these guys. So I'm going to do that by going ahead and I'll just make another object. Just randomly. And you can even pull it off to the side. It's not hurting anything. And I end up with this information. And it's got its original construction history. I don't really need that. I'll just delete its history. And so it's just DAG node and a shape node. And I will interrupt the flow. Let's open that up and open you up. And what we have here is our output and input polymesh. So I'm going to take this and put it into the in mesh. And what you'll see is I have this guy with all the poly splits and the extrudes, and this guy only has the extrudes now, and the information from the original mesh as well. If I had plugged in like a sphere or some other poly mesh, it would basically have replaced it with this, just as we've seen in other videos. So it doesn't really matter if this like was a man character or a dog or whatever that you'd modeled. You plug that in and it will change into that, and you'll get all those things up to that point in history. So it's got the history information up to that point. But it's also being shared amongst this other one. So that's one cool thing, is that you can, you know, duplicate part of the process and then continue on from that point. But I'm going to interrupt this flow and go blink like that. And so he has that, and you can see poly extrude face, and his outputs are the poly split. I grab this one and he only has the poly splits, but you can see the extrudes are there. This guy, of course, having these extrudes on it, I can go ahead, edit, delete by type history, and the end result is that he goes outwards. He doesn't have any information other than what his structure is, and he passes that on along to this guy, and this guy has the poly split. Now, to get rid of him, I can't just delete him, because if I delete him, it messes with a whole bunch of the other stuff, right? It basically deletes history altogether. So I want to keep that history. That was the thing that I'm talking about. But I can turn him into an intermediate object. And again, he just goes off and hides off in La La Land there. And I get my poly splits, and all is good and wonderful. So you can interrupt flow in between various different points, delete those pieces of history, and then move forward. So there's some potential uses for that methodology, and hopefully that was useful information. Cheers.